But we want to give the Lord our best praise on today as we remember that he got up, hallelujah, that death could not hold him down, hallelujah, and that we serve a risen Savior, hallelujah. Oh, magnify the Lord, because he is worthy to be praised. For he is worthy. Oh, magnify. Oh, for he is worthy. Oh, Hosanna. Blessed. Blessed be the rock. My salvation. Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Oh, magnify. For he's worthy. Oh, magnify. Oh, yes, he's worthy. Oh, Hosanna. Blessed, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna. Blessed, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hallelujah, hallelujah, blessed be the rock, Hosanna. Because he was crucified and laid behind a stone. the fall. Hallelujah. He that knew no sin took my sins. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today we have the victory. Hallelujah.
thank you for addressing our technical difficulties. We make a joyful noise because it is Resurrection Sunday. We can serve the Lord with gladness this morning because he who was crucified is risen from the dead. We come before his presence with singing because Easter tells us, according to 1 Corinthians 15, death is swallowed up in the victory. We enter God's gates with thanksgiving and God's courts with praise because we can say, like Paul, O death, where is thy sting? Grave, where is thy victory? Amen. We are here to celebrate the risen Savior. I don't know what you've come to do this morning, but I come to praise the Lord. I come to clap my hands. I come to sing and shout. I come to hear the word. I come to say he lives. Join me now for our invocation. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Lord, we lift your name on high this morning with thanksgiving in our hearts and praise from our lips because you raised your son Jesus from the dead. And we thank you. He lives in our hearts because you raised him from the dead. And we thank you. Your Holy Spirit is high, is moving in this church this morning because you raised him from the dead. And we thank you. Now, Lord, come, Holy Spirit, sweet heavenly dove. Stay right here with us, filling us with your love. And for these blessings, we lift our hearts in praise. For without a doubt, we know we will have been revived when we shall leave this place. Let your power fall on God's house on the Lord's day. Set our souls on fire with the anointing of the Holy Ghost through song and through word and prayer, and so that we might leave from here empowered to go forth and make disciples, to serve this present age, our calling to fulfill through Jesus Christ, the resurrected Lord. Amen. Amen. And thank God. Join with me and stand as we prepare to sing hymn number 468. It's one of those old hymns. One of those hymns we used to sing when I was a child. So that was a long time ago. But I ask you to join me this morning. Turn to page 468 in your hymnals, and we will sing the old hymn, My Faith Looks Up to Thee. Number 468 in the hymnal.
My faith looks up to thee,
thou Lamb of Calvary,
thou Lamb of Calvary, Savior divine.
Now hear me while I pray.
Take all my guilt away.
May thou rich grace impart
strength to my fainting heart, my zeal inspire. As thou hast died for me, oh, may my love to thee pure-born and changeless be. Dark maze I tread, and griefs around me spread,
Say amen. Amen. Turn now to page number 30 in the back of your hymnals for our responsive reading of the morning, Easter Sunday morning. And the scripture is found in Acts 13, verses 26 through 33. Page number 30 in the hymnal, at the rear of the hymnal. And it is there we find these words. Men and brethren, sons of the family of Abraham, and those among you who fear God, to you the word of this salvation has been sent. And though they found no cause for death in him, they asked Pilate that he should be put to death. Now when they had fulfilled all that was written concerning him, they took him down from the tree and laid him in a tomb. And we declare to you glad tidings, that promise which was made to the fathers. God has fulfilled this for us, their children, in that he has raised up Jesus. All, as it is also written in the second psalm, you are my son, today I have begotten thee.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen.
Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is one true church, apostolic and universal, whose holy faith let us now reverently and sincerely declare by the use of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. Our scripture reading this morning will be read by our sister Andrea Sands. It would help if you knew where the scripture is. John 19, verses 1 through 6. John 19, verses 1 through 6.
Good morning, St. James. I'm reading from the NIV version. Then Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged. The soldiers twisted together a crown of thorns and put it on his head. They clothed him in a purple robe and went up to him again and again, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews." And they slapped him in the face. Once more, Pilate came out and said to the Jews gathered there, "Look, I am bringing him out to you to let you know that I find no basis for a charge against him." When Jesus came out wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe, Pilate said to them, "Here is the man." As soon as the chief priests and their officials saw him, they shouted, "Crucify, crucify." But Pilate answered, "You take him and crucify him. As for me, I find no basis for a charge against him." The word of God, for the people of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. It is prayer time. Scripture reminds us that the effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. The word tells us, as believers, we are to pray and not faint. Our resurrected Lord set the example for the prayerful life. At the beginning of his ministry, spending 40 days in the wilderness in prayer and fasting. After he cast out a demon from out of a young boy in Mark 9, after the disciples were unable to do so, they asked him why they couldn't cast the devil out, and Jesus said to them, "This kind comes out only by prayer." We see him in the garden in Gethsemane, before he was arrested, praying intensely, asking God to take the bitter cup from him, and yet saying, "Yet not my will, but thine be done." And so even as Jesus in prayer sought to do God's will, come to this altar seeking the will of God for your situation, your question, your concern, your decision, your life, your fear, your future, your hope, your joy, your peace, your power, your anointing. Come praying for others in their situations. Come praying for our nation and our world. Come praying for the undeserved and underserved and marginalized. Come now to the altar as we prepare to go to God in prayer.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses. And the voice I hear falling on my ear, the song of God discloses, and he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other. Jesus, wonderful Jesus. It's Jesus in my soul, for I have touched the hem of his garment, and his blood has made me whole. Our Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning. We're thanking you for waking us up today. We're thanking you, Lord, for giving us a mind to press our way to your house. Lord, we come today to celebrate your resurrection. We've come today to thank you for your son, Jesus, who died on Calvary's cross. And today we celebrate his resurrection. We thank you, Lord, that he shed his blood for the redemption of mankind. Oh, we thank you, Lord, that he come to save us and to set us free. We thank you, Lord, that we can come and just kneel before you. Father, that we can bring our petitions before you. And Lord God, we don't have to worry about what anybody thinks or anybody says. Oh, Father, we thank you for resting and ruling on the altars of our heart, that you bring us peace, that you give us guidance, and most of all, Father God, that you give us mercy. We thank you because we know we don't deserve it. Oh, but we thank you that he paid it all of our debt, all of our faults, all of our sins are rested on that cross and in his resurrection. So today, Lord, we thank you. Lord, today we come humble as we know how, not for form or fashion. Lord God, not for what we're wearing or what we're going to have to eat later on. Father, just coming as your children. Oh, some come weary, Lord God. Some come burdened. Some come with joy. Oh, but still we come because we know you'll meet us where we are. We thank you, Lord, for those who are lying on their beds of affliction and how you minister to them. Oh, Lord, that you touch their fevered brow. Oh, Lord God, that you minister to the pain that might be going throughout their body. And then, Lord, we pray for those who are grieving. We pray for those who are mourning, continuously mourning, Lord God. We pray that you would minister to their souls. Touch them, Lord God, as only you can. We pray, Lord, for the shepherd of this flock, that he would bring us a word that would set our souls afire, that would convict us, that would guide us, that would just straighten us out where, Lord, we got crooks. Oh, Lord God, we just praise you today. We thank you for the gathering of families. We thank you for being able to be friends to one another. We thank you for being able to share the gospel and to shed the light throughout the land, Lord God, to tell them that you live. He lives. Christ Jesus lives today. You ask me how I know he lives, because he lives in me. And so, Lord, we're going through the hedges and the highways. We're going, Lord, with the strength that you give us today. And, Lord, we're just going to praise you throughout the ages. We're going to praise you till we can't shout it out anymore. Oh, Lord, because we love you today. We love you, Lord, because you loved us first. And Lord, you will love us from earth to victory. Oh, Lord, we just thank you today. We praise you today. If there's anything that we fail to ask for, Lord God, we know if it's within your will that you will grant it. And so, Lord, we ask that you look upon these who are before your altar. Lord, you know their need. You know their conditions. Father, just touch in the mighty name of Jesus. So that when we go from this place, we will just shout, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. He is the Lord of lords and the King of kings, and he shall reign forever and ever. And we ask these blessings in the precious name of Jesus the Christ. Let the church say, amen.
Praise the Lord, church. Come on, this is the day that the Lord has made. Amen. And I just want to check right now just to make sure we are in the right house. Make sure we are on the right Sunday. So if you could do me a favor and just check your neighbor and say, neighbor, did you sit next to the right person? Because this is Resurrection Sunday. And I thank God for waking me up this morning and starting me on my way. He allowed me to see another day, not because of what I deserve, but because of who he is. Do I have about five people to say, yep, that's why I'm here in church this morning? Because I serve a resurrected, an anointed, and a powerful king. Do I have a witness this morning that I came to praise the Lord? I came to worship the Lord. Because this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me, and the world can't take it away. Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. I just want to make sure we're in the right church. And I think, Reverend Clark, they're going to have to watch me be on fire today. Because if you don't want to praise him, I'm going to praise him today. Because God has been so good to me this year that all I can just say is thank you. I can Shabbat the Lord and say hallelujah. Come on, give God the highest praise. What's the highest praise? Say hallelujah. Say amen. Say hallelujah. Say amen. Hallelujah. 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 Certainly it's good to be in the house of the Lord. If you don't want to praise him, watch me praise him. Because you don't know my story, all the things that I've been through. But my worship this morning, it is for real. Amen. We thank God for life, health, and strength. I'm trying to pace myself. Y'all are looking at me. I'm going to give you something to look at in a minute. But it's all right because God is good. Amen. Amen. God has been so good. God has been so good. He has been so good. I stand before you this morning to prepare for the announcements. I want to ask that you just follow behind the back of your bulletin. Just want to reiterate, Bible study is now hybrid. Amen. The month of April, we are rolling out Bible basics. And we thank God that Reverend Dr. Clark is going to lead us in the Bible basics. And I want to be parenthetically clear to let you all know, just because you've been in the church for so long doesn't mean you know it all. And oftentimes, we got to go back, Elder Barrett, to the basics of how to understand and interpret the Bible. So we thank God for Reverend Clark, who's going to lead us this month, or maybe the Clarks, I believe, who's going to lead us this month of April in Bible basics. We talk about it in the AME Zion Church, tending to the means of grace. And the means of grace is just a big word of saying, are you going to Sunday service? Yeah. Are you going to prayer meetings? Yeah. Are you going to Bible study? Mm-hmm. So when you go on to glory, God's going to hold you accountable for tending to the means of grace. Amen. Mm-hmm. Our Rochester Syracuse District Conference is April 19th through the 20th. For those who are coming, please make sure you govern yourselves accordingly. And if there's any information you may be in need of, please let me know. Last couple of announcements. We have the Ithaca Eagles Club is having a chicken barbecue, amen, on April 6, 2024 at 161 Cecil Malone Drive. The flyer is also downstairs, thank you, in the foyer. There's a raffle of baskets taking place, so please let's celebrate those persons in the community because we hope and pray that they celebrate and confirm us as a church. Amen? Amen. Lastly, we want to thank God for Brother Arthur Buckner. Some of you may have not met him in person as he is in the wheelchair. He can't get up the stairs, but he is a diligent faith believer. He is also an artist. So he will be having an art exhibit called Hindrance and Flow. And it will be held on Cherry Gallery in Ithaca, New York from March 29th, so it's already started, until May 12th. So if you have some time between now and then, please support this young brother as he shows the work in the arts that he has created with his hands. Amen? Amen. All hearts and minds are clear. If we can stand to your feet, amen. First, we want to shout out, amen, all our visitors here for the first time. If you are a visitor, just wave at me. Let me know where you are. If you are a visitor for the first time, amen. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, little boy, little man. Amen. We thank God for you. If you are a visitor for the first time, we thank you for choosing St. James on this historic and this Resurrection Sunday. And if you are a member, can you do me a favor? Let's stretch across the aisle. Let's greet our neighbors. Tell them it's good to be seen on Resurrection Sunday. It's good to see God get you up this morning, starting you on your way. Amen. About three to five people, give them a hug, give them a handshake. Tell them good morning. Tell them this is the day that the Lord has made. Amen.
We want to know who owns
test two, test one. Test one, test two. Magnify the Lord with me. Whom the Son he has redeemed. Clap your hands, rejoice and sing. You are Lord of everything. I will bless the Lord. Bless. I will bless the Lord. That's good right here. Thank you.
And now, as we return to our seats, we prepare ourselves for our special Easter presentation for today.
The grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the grave, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. You came, you came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the cross to the grave, my debt to pay. From the grave to the grave, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name. Lord, I lift your name on. Oh, we lift you up, oh Lord. Oh, I lift your name.
Lord, I lift your name on
high. We need another microphone for
them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
You can sing.
We are going to read to you the Easter story. We will start with Zeke. Can you follow along? Zeke is going to read this page. When it's your turn,
Easter is
in a second. Okay.
Such an amazing time, a time to celebrate our Savior Jesus Christ. Jesus was the Son of God, a man who made people well and even saved people from death.
Very good. Go ahead, Kazaya.
Sadly, not everyone liked what Jesus did, but Jesus was loving and forgave anyone who hit him.
Jesus rode into the city of Jerusalem on Palm Sunday. People praised Jesus.
They sang, "Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord."
Jesus had clothes. Apostles to follow him. Jesus washed his feet off the apostles of to show his love for them.
After the Last Supper on Thursday, Jesus and his disciples were in a garden praying to pray.
One of the 12 apostles had Jesus arrested.
Jesus was going to be killed. The people who followed Jesus and loved him were very sad.
Jesus told his followers that he would return in their days.
On the third day, some woman came to the tomb of Jesus.
Jesus was gone. The tomb was empty.
Jesus' disciples were in a house. Jesus came to them. He returned from the dead.
Jesus told the disciples that whoever believes in him will live forever.
Jesus had saved us all from sin. We need to believe in him and obey his words.
This is the Easter story about how Jesus is living today. Jesus laid down his life for us so we could live. Thanks, Jesus, for every day, for all he did.
Amen.
Okay, we're going to need those. Hold on to them.
Promise I have in you.
We will now have, oh, they're not done yet. Okay, all right, tell me, all right.
Okay, Brother Amos, I know you're busy, but you can still answer the question. What's the Christian way to reference Easter? Happy Resurrection Sunday.
Happy Resurrection Sunday.
Okay, the other half of Zeke is not here today. Demir's not here to back you up, but I think you can do it. What are the four books in the Bible that teach us about Jesus' resurrection? What were here to?
Matthew and Mark. But Luke. John.
Sister Naomi is going to read Matthew chapter 28, verses 1 through 10.
In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see this. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. For fear of him, the keeper did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the woman, Fear not ye, for I know what ye seek, Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen. As he said, Come see the place where the Lord lay. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee, there shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. And they departed quickly from the sepulchre, with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, All hail. And they came and held him by the feet and worshipped him. Then said Jesus unto them, Be not afraid, go tell my brethren that they go into Galilee, and there shall they see me.
Okay. Brother Levi, what are the names of the two women who went into Jesus' tomb?
Mary Magdalene and Mary.
Isaiah. Who did the angel of the Lord instruct the two Marys to go tell about that Jesus had risen from the dead?
The disciples.
Very good. And who descended from heaven?
An angel of God.
Very good. Brother DJ, could you please read?
The first day of the week cometh Mary Magdalene early, when it was yet dark, into the sepulchre, and seeth the stone taken away from the sepulchre. Then she runneth and cometh to Simon Peter, and to whom the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and saith unto them, They have taken away the Lord out of the sepulchre, and we know not where they have laid him. Peter therefore went forth and told the other disciple, and came to the sepulchre. So they ran both together, and the other disciple did not outrun Peter and came first to the sepulchre. And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen cloth laying, yet he went not in. Then cometh Simon Peter following him, and went into the sepulchre, and seeth the linen clothes lie, and the napkin that was about his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but wrapped together in a place by itself. Then went in also the other disciple, which came first to the sepulchre, and he saw and believed. For as yet they knew not the scripture, that he must rise again from the dead. Then the disciples went away unto their home, their own home, but Mary stood without at the sepulchre weeping, and as she wept, she stood down and looked into the sepulchre, and seeth two angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. And they say unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? She saith unto them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they have laid him. And when she had thus said, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing, and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be a gardener, saith unto him, Sir, if thou have borne him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus saith unto her, Mary. She turned and saith unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, Master. Jesus saith unto her, Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord, and that he had spoken these things to her.
Now have our pre-sermonic selection, and after that, the next voice you will hear is that of Pastor Reverend, soon to be Dr. Terrence A. King.
The sun, where to stand in the morning, and who told the ocean you can only come this far, and who told the moon where to hide till evening, whose word alone can catch a falling star. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. All of creation testifies. Let this life within me cry. The very same God that spins things in orbit runs to the weary, the worn, and the weak, and the same gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken, they conquer death to bring So now he's alive. There's an empty grave. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer lives.
Amen. If you can grab your Bible, Nick, I need you to turn me up just a little bit more. Turn your Bible as John chapter 19, verses 1 through 6 was read for your hearing. I want to push that to the side. And I want us to go to Matthew chapter 28, beginning at verse 5 and reading to verse 6. Matthew chapter 28, verse 5, reading to verse 6. When you're there, say word. If you need more time, say hold on. If you're anywhere by the book of Revelation, say Lord help. Matthew chapter 28, beginning at verse 5 and reading to verse 6. Amen? And the Bible reads, the angel said to the women, do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. The word of God for the people of God, we say thanks be unto God. Let us say amen. For the time that is mine, I want to talk to you from this thought, this reflection, this sermon title, the power to get up. The power to get up. Would you bow your head for a moment of prayer? What a mighty God we serve. What an awesome God we serve. And Lord, right now for this time of sharing, God, hide me behind the cross so that the people under the sound of my voice, whether in person or online, hear Jesus and not Terrence. See Jesus and not Terrence. And God, as the preaching goes forth, may those hearing understand the true purpose of the resurrection. In your name we pray and we say amen. I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice, and it told thy love to me. But I long to rise in the arms of faith and be closer drawn to thee. Come on, if you know the song, sing it, draw me nearer. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Easter Sunday, for those of us who are saved, we call it Resurrection Sunday. Resurrection Sunday is the culmination of the Christian calendar. It's the realization of yet another opportunity to be humble, thankful, and repentant. Another chance just to tell God, thank you. A blatant reminder of the abounding grace of God. A flagrant recollection on mercy. Another time, Easter Resurrection Sunday, is another time for us just to praise his risen name. An ordained opportunity to worship. Worship means that you have to have a relationship with who God is. That you can't talk to Jesus, that you have to understand that even though some of us talk to Jesus, we can still go to hell. Even though some of us can be in Jesus' presence, we can still go to hell. Resurrection Sunday is evidence of one malefactor at the cross, as we talked about seven last words, that declares, if you be who you say you are, prove that to us. But there's a few people under the sound of my voice who can attest that Resurrection Sunday is a vivid, intimate reflection about some things we have overcome. Resurrection Sunday is about some things we have triumphed over. Resurrection Sunday is about some things we have travailed through, some things we have survived from, and some things we've got up from. Do I have anybody under the sound of my voice to say, Reverend King, if you don't preach another thing, the reason why I find myself up in here on a Sunday afternoon is because I understand that I've come through some things. I've had some triumph over some things. I've travailed through some things. I've survived through some things, and I've gotten up from some things that should have killed me. But thanks be to God to who he is in my life, that he has the keeping power over my life. The I'm so glad what should have killed me but didn't. That I'm so glad what should have wiped me out but didn't. The I'm so glad that what he sent me into, I didn't come out in mental psychosis, but I made it through. The someone under the sound of my voice, I'm so glad that what I've been through in my life, I did not place a needle in my arm to escape what's going on. I'm so glad that although I gambled it all away, God still renewed what I gambled away and got the victory out of it. I'm sure I came this morning, praise God, so you can look at me all you want to, but I understand on this Resurrection Sunday that I'm so glad that God has kept me despite when I should have been kept. Do I have about two people who can just say, thank God for keeping me? Thank God for keeping me. Did not have victory because the willpower to get up was stronger than the enticement to lay down. The willpower to get up was stronger than the enticement to stay down. The willpower to get up was stronger than the enticement to be down. Do I have anybody under the sound of my voice that is so happy that on this Sunday, March 31st, 2024, that you don't have medication to make you regulate your mind, but God kept you in perfect peace, that in the middle of what you're going through now, that you don't look like what you're going through, but thanks be to God that we find ourselves on Resurrection Sunday, because there is power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. Resurrection is the power in pressing through while carrying the blood-stained banner of victory before the battle is even over. Brother Morgan, songwriter said it best, don't wait until the battle is over, but shout now. And can I take it just a little bit further this morning? Not only should you just work, don't wait till the battle is over to shout now, but may I suggest, don't wait till the battle is over. Don't give up yet. Just tell your neighbor, don't give up. Don't give up. Just look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, don't give up. What they're talking about you in the workplace, don't give up. What the doctor's report says, don't give up. What your family, what's going on in your family relations, don't give up. What's going on in your church, don't give up. What's going on in this country, don't give up. What's going on in the world, don't give up. Someone say, don't give up. before there were Easter bunnies. Thank God the children left. They all gone. Amen. Before there were Easter bunnies and Easter baskets, and before we had to search all over the neighborhood to find an egg, and before we had to understand what a pastel color was, there was an old rugged cross. And may I suggest that we may not fully understand the power of the resurrection, what Jesus endured and overcame. Last weekend in Mark, we celebrated Jesus' entry into Jerusalem. And although we said it was triumphant, it really wasn't. Laying our garments at his feet and waving palms in the air saying, what? Oh, yeah, I was on church last Sunday. I was at church last Sunday. Yelling, waving the palm trees and saying, Hosanna. But Sister Zenobia, it's interesting enough that the same crowd that would cry Hosanna is the same crowd that would declare and suggest crucify him. May I parenthetically pause for the young adults under the sound of my voice. Be careful of people who equally are quick to praise and destroy you. Be careful of people who praise you publicly and talk behind your back privately. But Pastor Lori Thornton would put it this way. She would say that churches have wiped the cross clean or portray it as a Christless cross. Have you ever considered or remembered the physical abuse Jesus suffered on our behalf? As James Cone said, the lynching of Jesus. When arrested, he was bound by the soldiers. Those who have been handcuffed would testify that it's very painful to move when handcuffs are on your body. Mm-hmm. Jesus spent the entire night standing trial before an improperly convened Jewish court. He was not only the victim of lies and ridicule, but he was spat on. Mm-hmm. He was blinded. He was blindfolded. He was slugged, and he was, as John says, slapped by members of the Sanhedrin. And to add salt onto the wounds and the already tumultuous ordeal, then in Mark chapter 14, verse 65, Brother Tali, the guards took him and they beat him. In the morning, Jesus was tried before Roman authorities for the purpose of gaining a death sentence. And during the series of trials, Jesus was again mocked and taunted as an impersonator. The soldiers continued twisting together a crown of thorns and set it upon him. His brows were punctured deeply by the long thorned briar. The soldiers repeatedly struck Jesus on the head with a staff, and they arrogantly spit on him as a result. Jesus is your Jesus, the Jesus that y'all have at home that looks so nice and shiny and polished, the Jesus that we still leave on the cross when we wear it around our neck. That Jesus, his face had been beaten so bad that he was swollen and his eyes were blackened. His nose bloodied by the abusive Roman soldiers who were anxious to punish an insurrectionist. Then Pilate ordered Jesus flogged. What does that mean, to be flogged? I'm glad you asked about it. It's when bits of lead and stone are made in the whip of some type of leather. And the slashing with instrument of terror, that when you hit someone with the flog and the lead and the stone, that when you ripped it from their flesh, some of their flesh would get shredded as a result of the pulling back. This is the Bible. I'm in the Word. Occasionally even tearing out an eye or slicing open an eye, Jesus was led like a sheep to the slaughter. And when forced to carry his own cross, I know y'all talk about bearing your own cross, but the cross that Jesus had to bear wasn't all nice and shiny, but the cross Jesus had to bear was a beam that rubbed Jesus' shoulders raw. That when he stumbled and fell on the rough streets, he skinned his elbows and his knees. Can y'all see this Jesus that you're talking about? Could you imagine yourself in that situation? I'm so glad, Reverend Clark, that I'm not Jesus, because if the Lord gave me the opportunity to do what he did to him for the sake of men, I would be all in my flesh and tell him I'm not going to be able to do it. You're going to have to find someone else to take that place, but I won't be able to do it, just fairly alone at the fact that they spat on me. But the crucifixion was horrible. The crucifixion was so horrible that the NIV study Bible states that only slaves or criminals and offenders of the Roman citizens were executed in this manner. Jesus, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, wasn't a slave nor a criminal, but they treated him as if he was. Who am I talking to this morning, this afternoon, that you are standing and sitting up in this church in St. James on March 31st, and you yourself have survived people talking bad about you and beating you and thought that they killed you and got you to take you off a route. But thanks be to the God that I serve, that I'm still being able to stand and come into God's house, not with my hand out, with my hand up, still declaring that this joy that I have, it wasn't my neighbor, it wasn't my mother, it wasn't my father, but it only had to be the hand of the Lord that was on me. Someone say, I know that's right. Our sensibilities can't imagine the horror of one's hands and feet being nailed to a cross and one's body being suspended naked above the gawkers and the gloaters below. Every breath was a struggle. That's right. For Jesus. That's right. Every movement produced jarring pain. But yet Jesus suffered the cruel and inhumane torture of crucifixion for 6 agonizing hours for us. I thought the church went up in that part. 6 agonizing hours he has been in pain. Some of us can't even stand a needle that only lasts for about 10 seconds. But yet you sitting here looking at me on Resurrection Sunday when I tell you that your King, your Lord, and your Savior was on for 6 hours dealing with the pain and the hurt of having blood and flesh being ripped from his body and having so insurmountable pain that it only had to be that the fact that he was all man and all God at the same time, that he could endure what he has endured. But now we sit here on Sunday afternoon on Resurrection and we are able to say thank you, God, that even the things that I've been through in my life, I'm still able to press on, I'm still able to worship, I'm still able to praise, I'm still able to come to church and give you that which is me, because I understand that if you bear it for 6 hours, I could bear it just a little bit longer. Yeah. That I can bear it just a little bit longer. This is why, this ain't even my notes. This is why I'm so cautious, Sister Hickman, with people who say they want to go into ministry. Because if you want to go into ministry, just look at Jesus. Ministry is not all flowers and roses. Most of ministry is you being battling yourself and battling people around you, just trying to do what the Lord has placed on your heart. That's what ministry is. Don't tell me you want to work in ministry in the moment that it get hard. You tell me, oh, Pastor, I don't know if that's the one the Lord gave me. The devil is a lie. You better stick right where you are and travail through it, because I know a man who was able to let you know that I can still push through, not 1 hour, not 2 hours, not 3 hours, not 4 hours, not 5 hours, but 6 hours I can deal with it. And we're struggling with the 6 months. So Jesus finds himself on the cross. An ancient letter suggests that when Mary, Jesus' mother, was escorted to the crucifixion, she looked up at the tree, at the 3 crosses, and asked, which one is he? That this mother couldn't even recognize her own child. Which one is he? Jesus may have been beaten beyond recognition. And then the prophet Isaiah predicted that many would be appalled at him. And it says, Isaiah 52 and 14, his appearance was so disfigured beyond that of any man, and his form marred beyond human likeness. That's how bad they beat him. All this and more Jesus endured in our place. With all he endured, he still had enough to reposition his body. and gather pockets of air to speak and declare, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. With the flesh coming off of his body and open to the air, he still positioned himself on the cross and said, verily I say unto you, thou shalt be with me in paradise. Not yesterday, not tomorrow, but today. With all that he was going through, Brother Hickman, he repositioned himself and had the audacity to set women in history and ministry by declaring, woman, behold thy son. Son, behold thy mother. Am I in the word? With all that was going through, Reverend Welch, he had the audacity to refix himself and still declare, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? And if you thought that was just enough, he even positioned himself a little bit more further and still declare, I thirst. But that wasn't done. He wasn't done yet, because even as we find in our sixth word that he positioned himself on the cross and still declared, even though it seemed like they had victory, that it was finished. But oh my God, this is how we find ourselves on the eve of Resurrection Sunday, that now we see on the seventh word that he positioned himself yet again with his nails nailed in his feet and his hands, and he still declared, Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit. Anybody happy that Jesus still spoke in the middle of his situation, even when he didn't know how to get through it, he still had some strength to say something?
Yeah.
Resurrection Sunday is a reminder that your new year is reset. That as we begin, Brother Gordy, to walk about this earth after the resurrection glow, as we find Jesus talking in the middle of his mess, why you and I can talk in the middle of our trials. Do I have any witness under the sound? The reason why I come into church the way I come is because I've survived some things in my life. And I'm an advocate. I'm a poster child for the fact that God be with me. I'm a poster child that if no man be against me, God is for me. The reason why I find myself here on Sunday afternoon here on Resurrection is because I'm a survivor. Destiny Child said it best. I'm a survivor. You thought what you had, I'm still a survivor. Anybody a survivor under the sound of my voice? The power of our faith, y'all still with me? Is not the crucifixion, but in the resurrection. That's the power of Christian faith, that you have a get up spirit in you. Just turn to your neighbor and say, do you have a get up spirit? You have a get-up spirit. I don't remember what this toy was, but there was a toy when I was growing up. And you would inflate it, and it would have a base. It would have some type of foundation that when you would go to punch it, it would bounce right back. I'm about to preach right now. But that when you would be able to go to punch it, it automatically bounced right back. And I saw a video on TikTok the other day about a little boy punching that same toy, but he wasn't prepared for the bounce back. And may I submit this morning, that's why you find yourself here in the church on Sunday afternoon, because some of us are the poster children for the fact that what was meant for evil, we were able to bounce back from what God had for us. That's why I'm so glad for Resurrection Sunday, that I'm under the sound of people who bounce back from cancer, bounce back from depression, bounce back from insecurity, bounce back from being broke, bounce back from being talked about, bounce back from being ruled over, bounce back from being able to be what God has called. Someone has been bouncing back because you're still here on this Sunday morning, because I got a get up spirit, because my bounce back is real. But the toy was able to bounce back because it had a strong foundation. That's why we be able to declare that at the cross, where I first saw the light and the burdens of my heart rolled away. They rolled away because I'm anchored in who God is. I'm anchored in who God is. Like a ship tossed and driven, yet I'm still anchored because I got a bounce back anointing on my life. The power of the faith of the resurrection, y'all still with me?
Yeah.
It's not in the crucifixion, but it's in the resurrection. Brother Gavin, I like old school music. And when I reflect on old school music once in a while, I try to think about, well, what do they mean? I know auntie and grandma be dancing to it, but I'm not understanding what this means. What are they talking about? Well, there's a song that I want to introduce or want to bring to your remembrance that leads me while the reason why we have to get up and have a bounce back anointing is because we have to remember what God has already done for us in the past. There's a, come here, Earth, Wind, and Fire. Earth, Wind, and Fire said a song that says, do you remember? Yeah. No, don't y'all sing it. We in church now. The 21st night of September. Love was changing the minds of pretenders while chasing the what? The clouds away. Then I start getting vexed. What happened on the 21st of September? I'm not sure what happened on the 21st of September, but in my imagination, I can recall that maybe Earth, Wind, and Fire were testifying that something that was so powerful in their relationship building was something to write a song about. I miss you already. Well, that's why we find ourselves up in here on Resurrection Sunday, because we got to remember all that God has gotten us through this past year, that God has gotten us through a pandemic, God has gotten us through a recession, God has gotten us through death, life, and famine. That's why I come to church on Sunday morning with a remembering anointing, because I know if he brought me back from then, the same God back then is the same God today and forevermore. Turn to your neighbor and say, do you remember? Come on back, mother. I'm going to bring it back. Donnie McClurkin would put it this way. He said it best, for a saint is just a sinner who fell down and got up. Because we fall down, but then we get up. We got to remember, we have to have a rewind spirit, Brother Gibran, on what God has brought us from and bringing us to. That's why we find ourselves in this scripture. Anybody under the sound of my voice can remember on some things God has gotten you through, can remember on some things, some people God has allowed you to navigate, can remember on some situation God interceded on your behalf on the workplace, can remember what God has done for your family, even in the absence of your presence. That's why I'm so happy about Resurrection Sunday, because I can still declare the blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary, it will never lose its power. Never. It will never lose its power. The power to get up. What does this have to do with you beyond today? You do know that after the resurrection, there was still a moment where there was no assemblance of Jesus. And I want to submit this afternoon to you that after this afternoon, after the benediction, after we take our members' photo, that there may not be a semblance of Jesus. But the good message is, the news is that if you just keep trudging through and keep your head steadfast and still keeping your eyes lifted up to the hills from which cometh your help, that the only Lord who is able to keep you from falling will still keep you from falling. That's why I'm so happy on this Resurrection Sunday that I can agree with what Mother said when she said that I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shores, sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea, he heard my despairing cry, and from the water he lifted me. Now safe am I. Anybody happy that they are safe from the waters when you're tossed and driven backwards and forward? Anybody happy that he lifted you when you couldn't be lifted? Anybody happy that has a thank you, Lord, in their spirit? Anybody happy that I have an I made it anointing on my life, that I'm so glad that I just came to Sunday services after just to tell God, thank you for Jesus. Oh, thank you for Jesus. Anybody happy for Jesus? That I made it to yet another Resurrection Sunday. When I counted my own self out, God, you still gave me remnants of your glory. When I counted my own self out, I was still able to confirm that I gotta get up from where I am and keep on pressing on. When I was down and sinking deep and sent far from the peaceful shore, I had to get up and understand who the master of the sea was. Anybody under the sound of my voice is happy that they have the power in getting up. There's power in getting up. That's why I'm so happy about this song that says, "It's Amazing Grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but..." Yeah, we all went to the same church. We went to the same church. "I was blind, but now I see." So my brother and my sister, as we find ourselves on this Resurrection Sunday, I want us to be humble that we are still alive. I want us to be thankful that we are still alive, because someone did not wake up this morning. Someone was called on home, but Lord, the Lord saw fit to make sure that my bedroom wasn't the four walls of a mortuary, but that my bedroom became just a springboard for my get up, that I was able to have just a reasonable portion of my mind and was able to turn to the right or left of my bed and allow my feet to touch the floor. And the fact that I had activity of my limbs and was able to put my feet on the floor was a hallelujah already this morning. And then I was able to get from my bedroom and go about my day and prepare for what God would have me to do. That the water in my sink was still running good, and there wasn't no issue with what it was. And then I went to the kitchen and ate breakfast. I'm already preaching. Ate breakfast, and there was food in the refrigerator. Even when I remember times where I had to put a little sugar sandwich together when we didn't have it all together. And when I came up in a household where Grandma had to feed us off of government cheese. Do I have church off government cheese? But I'm so glad now that I can go into the fridge and choose what I want to choose and then put on clothes on my back, because I can remember when I had to borrow my cousin's clothes just to make it work. But thanks be to God that my closet is so filled, I got to discern what I want to put on to come to church on Sunday morning. I'm ready to go, musician. But ain't you so glad that even when you put your clothes on, if you drove here, you put yourself in the car and you begin to put the key in the ignition. And some of us, we often pray to make sure God let this car start. But thanks be to God, we are at a page in our life where that when we don't even think twice that the car is going to start, and we gets us from point A to point B, and then you walk into the house of God and still come to the pews and just sit on who God is. But I decree and declare, I'm going to kill every demon, every naysayer in the name of Jesus, that if you believe in who God is and you believe in the resurrection of Jesus, do me a favor, stand to your feet and tell God, thank you for life, health, and strength. God, tell God thank you for who he is. Tell God thank you for what he's doing. Tell God thank you for the resurrection. Tell God thank you for life, health, and strength. Tell God thank you. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Thank you, Lord, for what you did for my mother. God, thank you, Lord, for what you did for my father. God, you've been a way maker. You've been, oh Lord, a miracle worker. You've been a promise keeper. God, you've been a light in darkness. Somebody say, give God glory for all that he's done in your life. That I don't mind praising God, because I understand there's power in the name of who Jesus is. Oh, that the blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary, it never lost its power, because it reaches to the highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. The blood that keeps me from day to day, today to day. I'm going to preach myself from day to day to day today. It was the blood on Monday and Tuesday. It was the blood on Wednesday and Thursday. It was the blood on Friday and Saturday. Now, this Sunday morning, someone can declare the blood. Grab your seat. Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Y'all can help me preach this. I've got to do like Jesus and have a get up spirit. I got to do like Jesus and have a get-up spirit. I don't know who I'm talking to, my brother and my sister. Wherever you are, just get up. Do me a favor. Slap five with three people. Say, get up. Wherever you are, just get up from where you are. Wherever you are, just get up from where you are. Wherever you are, just get up from where you are. And since we find ourselves on a Sunday, Resurrection Sunday, Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. They hung him high. They stretched him wide. He hung his head. For me, he died. But, someone say, but. That's the good news. But, someone say, but. But that's not how the story ends. Because in 3 days, he rose again. Anybody know he rose? Didn't he rise? He rose again on Sunday morning. Early Sunday morning, he rose again with all power in his hand. Someone say, get up, get up, get up.
Get up.
Now, Jesus got up on Resurrection Sunday so that we can have that bounce back anointing. That what the devil meant for evil, that we're able to bounce back and do keep on strutting. That whatever the enemy meant for evil, we able to bounce back and keep on going. That whatever's going on in my life, that's why God placed it in my possession, because I got to have the anointing to bounce back from where I am. Anybody happy that they have the strength to bounce back from where they are? I'm so happy that we bounce back. Grab a seat. That's not how the story ends. Because in 3 days, he rose again. This Resurrection Sunday, the frailty of life is more bold than ever before. We don't know the day nor the hour. But we celebrate a risen King. And I want to be, we got security, I'm going to say it, but I'm going to say it anyway. I want to be really clear as we talk about hell and heaven. If the metric to going to heaven was our behavior, none of us will be going. Do I have a church? That's why we got to be careful of people who assume to look saved. Those who assume to be righteous. And all the while, when they go back home, they're nothing but devils. But when we talk about salvation, what it really means is this thing called life, we're going to always mess up. That's why it's called a journey. But most of all, we have to be careful who we believe during the journey. So Resurrection Sunday reminds us that we have to believe despite what's going on in our schools, despite what's going on in our family, despite what's going on in the justice system, what's going on in the world, that we have a name above all names that allows us to get up from where we are and keep pushing through. Resurrection Sunday reminds us that the power of get up is essential, because if we don't get up, the devil wins. And I want to submit to you this afternoon, I don't want the devil to win over myself. I don't want the devil to win over my children. I don't want the devil to win over my family. I don't want the devil to win over my coworkers. I even don't want the devil to win over my enemies, because I understand there's power in resurrection. That he rose again on Sunday morning, not with some power, but all power in our hand, in his hand. The word of God for the people of God, we say thanks be unto God. Let the church say amen. At this time, if you can please stand, all those under the sound of my voice can please stand. Resurrection Sunday is your reset. Not reset for everything to be all taken care of, but reset just to have, as my grandmother say, a little bit more fight, a little more get up in your spirit, Or as the holiness say, a little more get up in your shana na. That's what we need. But in order to be able to get up, you have to be born and born again. The doors of the church are open for two reasons. One, if you are in need of salvation, what better day to develop this new relationship than on Resurrection Sunday? And the doors of the church are open for someone in the sound of my voice who may be in need of a church home, a covering. St. James AME Zion Church is good ground. And if you look for a perfect church, it's not this one. Because the moment we walked across the threshold of this church, it became imperfect. But we're all in this together. And lastly, with every head bowed, every eye closed, I want to know who I'm praying for this Resurrection Sunday. If you heard the message, say, Reverend King, I heard that there's power in the get up, but I'm struggling with bouncing back. Just lift up your hand. I want to make sure I know who I'm praying for. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my brother. Reverend King, not only am I struggling with getting back up, but Reverend King, I'm struggling with being my own worst enemy. Just slip up your hands. Just slip up your hands. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my brother. And not only, Reverend King, am I struggling with the get up, I'm struggling with being my own worst enemy, but Reverend King, I'm also struggling not speaking life into my own situation. Just slip up your hands. I want to know who I'm praying for. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my brother. Gracious God, in the name of Jesus, God, on this Resurrection Sunday, God, you deserve all the praise and the glory. And God, for my brother and my sister who lifted up their hand, struggling with the get up spirit, God, would you deal with them on your own time and remind them, help them remember what you've already gotten them through. And God, affirm and confirm in them that you're the same God back then, today, and forevermore. And for my brother and my sister under the sound of my voice, who's dealing with the issue of their own, of them being their own worst enemy, God, we come against right now anything that does not give you glory, any thought that does not increase our ministry, any thought that does not increase our relationship with you. We come against any thought that does not give you glory in the name of Jesus. And God, for my brother and my sister who is struggling lastly with speaking life into themselves, God, on this Resurrection Sunday, we speak life right now. That God, whatever be done on earth, be done in heaven. So God, right now in this season of our new resurrection, Lord, whatever you're doing in this season, don't do it without us. So God, if you're healing this season, don't do it without us. If you're blessing this season, God, don't do it without us. If you allow us to worship you this season, God, don't allow us to do it without you. Lord, we need you on this Resurrection Sunday. And God, even as we talk about resurrecting some things, in full transparency, we need to kill some things as well. So God, we come against bad thoughts, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. We come against anything for those persons under the sound of my voice, prevents them from worshiping and prevents them from praising. That God, we do decree and declare a season in the life of St. James where we'll be able to worship freely and praise because we understand who you are, whose we are, and what you're capable of doing. So God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your resurrection power and your blood. And God, before we leave, we're going to recommit ourselves to you. In your name we pray and we say amen. So part of that prayer I did not finish because I want this altar flooded. We're going to recommit ourselves to God on Resurrection Sunday. So everyone on the sound of my voice, if you can make your way to the altar, we're going to sing the sinner's prayer. And even if you've been saved, it's okay to say it as many times as you can. But the altar is open. And maybe not for you, but someone who's not here this afternoon. We're just going to do this real quickly. If you can just come to the altar, amen. You're just going to repeat after me. I'm just going to give you the prayer. You're just going to repeat, and we're just going to move forward. But on this Resurrection Sunday, what better day to recommit yourself to salvation than on Resurrection Sunday? Amen, amen. We need about three more. I'm not moving on until we get the three people that the Holy Ghost told me is still waiting to come. We need about three more people, amen, to come to the altar as we prepare to pray to God as we we rededicate our lives to him again. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my brother. Amen. If don't feel if the three already came, there's still more room at the table. There's still more room at the table. There is still more room at the table for this Resurrection Sunday. Do me a favor. I want everybody under the sound of my voice to repeat after me. Lord Jesus, I repent of my sins and surrender my life. Wash me clean. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, that he died on the cross for my sins and rose again on the third day for my victory. I believe that in my heart and make confession with my mouth that Jesus is my Savior and Lord. That Jesus is my Savior and Lord. And that Jesus is my Savior and Lord. Let those say amen, amen, and amen. Lord, if you're healing in this season, don't do it without me. Don't do it without me. Lord, if you're blessing in this season, Lord, don't do it without me. Don't do it without me. Lord, whatever you're doing, don't do it without me. Don't do it without. Do me a favor and give God a hand clap of praise this morning. Thank you, those at the altar. Thank you. As you go to your seat, amen. We thank God for you, you, and you. Amen. As we prepare ourselves to go further in this service, amen. As we prepare to go further in this service, we want to make sure we prepare to sow into God's house our tithes and our offering. I wanted to make sure that we had enough time to do our membership photo today and then go about our various locations for this Easter Sunday, this Resurrection Sunday observance, amen? If you can grab your tithes and your offering and place those in your right hand as the media ministry will load up our electronic giving. Those who like to give electronically, we have Venmo available as well. I want to make sure that we are diligent in our giving for this Resurrection Sunday and that you are doing your level best to bless God's house, amen? Once you have your offering, please place it in your right hand. The right hand is the hand of fellowship. And you can stand to your feet as we will consecrate it and bless it for God's glory. Amen. And even if you don't have anything to give on this Resurrection Sunday, please give, please lift it up as with a spirit of expectancy that God still supplies all your needs. Gracious God, we thank you for the ability to give. Now, God, whether we're giving out of lack or abundance, God, we ask that you consecrate this to your service for your glory and your anointing. And God, we are so humble on this Resurrection Sunday to know that we can't beat your giving no matter how hard we try. In your name we pray and we say amen. As we sow our offerings into you, pressed down, shaken together, we say amen. At the directions of the ushers, we'll bring our tithes and offering, cheerfully giving amen to God on this Resurrection Sunday. Amen. Thank you. things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee.
All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given
thee. Amen. You may be seated in his presence. I believe the children, they're not coming back up from Children's Church, right? Okay. The children are downstairs, I believe, with their Easter celebration or Easter acknowledgement, i.e. they are being sugared up right now, probably. So y'all already know how it goes on Easter, that when the kids come, we sugar them up. But praise be to God, we send them with their parents. Amen. Amen. Let the parents navigate how to deal with them. Amen. For the rest of the day. Okay. So, amen. So the adults get sugar as well. Amen. Amen. So please make sure that as you prepare to leave this place with never God's presence, you go downstairs and grab your Easter bag for the adults as well as for those children who may not be present. Maybe you have extra. You will also grab those for those who you have at home. Amen. Any last minute announcements before we prepare to leave this place with never God's presence? Yeah. So the photo, is the sun outside? I can't see. The lights are bright up here. I can't really tell. All right. Well, we would be going in front of the church, amen, for the photo, for this member's photo. So please meet us after the benediction. Give about maybe 10 minutes or so. We'll meet in the front, and then we'll take a membership photo. I'm asking if you are not a member but are available to actually take the photo. We actually got a photographer for it, but he just texted me while I was in the pulpit that he couldn't make it as a result of a family emergency. And he himself tried to look for 3 different photographers in the area to come in his place, but he didn't. So just like how we do, we know how to pivot. Amen. We're going to still make it work. So we're going to ask again 10 minutes after the benediction. We'll meet downstairs for our members photo, and then we'll go about our business for this Easter Resurrection Sunday. Amen. Let us bow our head. Gracious God, we thank you for what our ears have heard and what our eyes have seen. God, we're so happy that you rose again. And God, we're so humble that we have the get up anointing. So Lord, as we prepare to leave this place, but never your presence, you alone know what this week has in store for us. But God, would you give us the bounce back to prove, oh God, that there's power still in the resurrection. So God, as we leave this place, but never your presence, go before us, behind us, to the left and to the right, so that if it be your will, God, you allow us to come back to this meeting place, this ship of Zion, and still declare it was good to be in your hand. Now unto him who was able to keep us from falling and present us faultless. God, we're so happy that we have an advocate with the Father and the person of the name Jesus, who is the only risen King. Jesus, who is the only risen King. Jesus, who is the only risen King, we pray and we say amen, amen, and amen, amen. Forever and ever. 10-minute timer. Again, we're going to meet downstairs in 10 minutes, weather permitting.